Everybody, it's Paul Colligan here to show you something I think is pretty cool. Here is Twitter. I'm going to do a refresh. You can see nothing new here. We've got a promoted tweet from American Express, and we've got this tweet from me. Let's pull up my iPhone with Tweetbot. There's the iPhone. You can see it's the same content, and let's pull up the content that I want to tweet. Now, you can tweet with Siri by setting up the texting interface. It's not that complicated. That's not the purpose of this video. But let me show you what I mean here, okay? Let's tweet with Siri. Text Twitter.
What do you want to say to Twitter?
500 years of video are consumed every day on YouTube, period. How much of it is yours? %CT.
I updated your message. It says, 500 years of video are consumed every day on YouTube. How much of it is yours, CT? Ready to send it?
Yes.
Okay, I'll send your message.
And so there we are. We now have tweeting through Siri. And if we take here a second to refresh the page, it should show up fairly soon here. It does take a minute or two to get through the gateway. Let's do a refresh. There we go. What does this %CT mean? What does this %CT do? That is what I'm going to show you next. So here's my blog, paulcolligan.com. Most recent posting is about the Google Hangout, about Google Hangouts that I'm doing. Let me show you the tool, IFTTT, ifthisthenthat.com. And basically what this is it's a system where you set up channels. And in these different channels, you can assign your Buffer account, your Craigslist account, your Evernote account, whatever account you want to assign. It has a whole bunch of them. And then what you could do are you could do these really cool if this, then that type of situations. I'll give you an example of them. Here you've got, you know, if iTunes tweets about the free app of the week, it'll send you an email. It'll text you the weather every morning. It'll put tweets into a Dropbox file. It'll save photos from Instagram to Dropbox. The implications of this are pretty staggering. Let me show you one that I use. Go to My Recipes. We're going to take a look at this first one here. If Twitter, then WordPress. We're going to take a look at this one. And basically, we're calling this one Twitter to WordPress. If you want to look this up inside of If This Then That, it is recipe ID 134-8826. I didn't develop this one. I tweet a little bit for my own use, but you can see what happens here. Basically, if I have a tweet with a certain hashtag, you see %CT. If we go here to Twitter, we'll see %CT. That is my code that I want this to trigger what is happening in If This Then That. So basically, if there's a new tweet with me by the sound by the hashtag CT, that stands for content timeline, it will create a post. And the title will be the text without the hashtag, the text. And then I actually set up the fact that it's a link. I set it up internally to my blog with the category Twitter timeline. And I have the following tags in it. Now, if you notice here, this is not in my account at this point because the event hasn't triggered yet. If this, then that triggers about every 15 minutes or so. But if we scroll down a little bit, you can see an example of it here. You can see an example of it here. For example, next, the most viral of YouTube videos have the worst production values. Let's take a look at that. You can see the most viral of YouTube videos have the worst production values. I have the %CT for content timeline there. Again, we'll go back to this page and we'll hit the refresh. Again, you can see nothing has happened. Instead of making you wait 15 minutes, one of the nice things about If This Then That is you do have the ability to trigger something immediately. So what we're going to do is we're going to have it checked now. You can see the last time it was triggered was 3 days ago. I'm going to do a quick trigger here, or a quick check. And then we will do last triggered less than a minute ago. And so now if we go over to paulcolligan.com and we hit a refresh, you'll see that we've got the posting now from Twitter. Stuff. 500 years of video consumed every day on YouTube. Now I am tweeting with Siri that is going to Twitter here and then being picked up by If This Then That over to my blog. Using stuff readily available, I could tweet with Siri, I could tweet with whatever my favorite Twitter application is of choice. It could be the web interface, it could be a desktop app, a phone app, doesn't matter what it is. But now I am doing this all live. I'm tweeting to my, what I refer to as my content timeline. It's all automatic. I don't have to pull open Twitter, and I'm pretty excited about it. So there it is. There's some information. I hope you can put it to good use. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Bye.